But moving on, now that you mentioned, we've sort of moved into the more foreign policy aspect of the United States. And what I found very fascinating and interesting was how you use the story of Little Bighorn and General Custer as sort of in a metaphor for the American self-image of the frontier and of how one operates in the world. Mm-hmm. Could you tell us a little bit about why Custer was so fascinating for you and why you chose to use him as that type of image?
Yeah, the first reason was very practical. It was on my way, Custer. It is indeed in that way also a travel story, and I was very lucky that Steinbeck traveled from east to west and later back, but he traveled faster and faster because he got homesick, but he traveled very well in the beginning. And the American history, the history of the USA, the history is of course with the Indians much older, but the new history of America starts with the colonization in the east. So all along those travels, you could also a little bit build up a historical story. And then, then with Custer, when you see this history and you follow this history and study it a little bit, you see slowly on how the Indians are pushed away more and more. The first month of century, the American colonists in the East Coast desperately needed the Indians because there was big business coming already from the rest of America, especially trading in fur coats and so on and so on, and not in coats but in furs, and the Indians were the only ones who really traveled through the whole continent, and the most, with a few exceptions, the most European colonists didn't came so far, and it was still 1806, I believe, that for the first time. Was it Clark and the other one, David?
Lewis
and Clark, was their expedition really went from the middle of America, from St. Louis to the West Coast. Of course, the Spaniards were already through Mexico also, came to the West Coast, but really straight to the country. They were the first. So they were very dependent of the Indians. But after Lewis and Clark, the colonists dared more and more, and the Indians were not a solution anymore, but became more and more a kind of a problem. And I think also there are two groups of involuntary Americans, that are the blacks, they were brought to America as slaves, and the Indians. And especially the Indians were so different from the American self-image as in all everything. The Americans saw themselves as a battle against the nature, and saw themselves as builders, rather materialistic. As doers and as taming the wilderness, while the Indians were part of the original country, were spiritual. You can say the more I studied about this relation between the American colonists and the Indians, how more I understood that the Indians were the contra world of the Americans. So they and somehow they had to, not perhaps to wipe it away, but a lot of Indians were died already on the diseases and wars and so on, but the remaining Indians were pushed away more and more. And the Custer battle was the last resistance, last great resistance of the Indians. For the last time, the American army was beaten by the Indians in the battle of the Little Bighorn. And you see there also already all kinds of mistakes the American army and the American government made when they were mingled in other wars from Vietnam to Iraq. You see already the basics with General Custer. Custer, the big mistake of Custer was, I think, that he thought that because he was an American and because he was white and because he was a very rational and enlightened thinking man, he was better and he would win always. And
well, one of the fascinating things about that battle is that, well, you've written about the shot in Sarajevo as well. And when you read about that, I had always learned that, you know, there's an anarchist who goes up and he shoots, end of story. But when you read about it, it's really just like a Three Stooges episode. There's all these mistakes along the way. Whereas Custer sort of, he seems, in your depiction, almost like this bumbling, I don't know, Woody Allen on a horse or something. He has no idea what he's doing all of a sudden. And the soldiers are all spread out everywhere.
And he is blind with megalomania and optimism. And he cannot imagine that the Indians can organize themselves also very well. And that the Indians have also guns. And even when they have arrows, they are so very good shooters. And for every soldier were 100 arrows. And that's a lot. And he couldn't imagine that the Indians had their own guerrilla techniques. So you saw, for instance, with the defeat of Custer, you saw in a kind of mini scale already. I was there on the Little Horn and I saw, at the moment I saw almost these Vietnamese on their bikes doing the same thing.
So did you say Vietnamese? The Vietnamese?
The North Vietnamese and the Viet Cong. Of course, it was not only a lost battle, but it was also a collusion of mentalities and a collusion of ways of thinking. Mm.